Rob Stone, Randy Peterson, welcoming you back to match number one of the Motor City Open. Bill O'Neill taking on Tommy Jones. We pick this up. O'Neill, bottom of the sixth, up 14. Three, six, seven, ten.
Good ball speed, but this ball is left of target by two boards. And on this oil pattern, just not enough oil in the middle to hold that ball online.
Open frame for O'Neill while we were gone. This is Bill in the fourth. He went nine spare and then eight spare in the fifth. Tommy Jones in the fifth, his third strike of the match. And in the sixth, an open frame, which is what O'Neill just had in the sixth as well.
Oof.
So now here's O'Neill in the seventh. Oh, the late tap.
A little leaner. Show that python. Show that python, Billy. This is going to be a half pocket 10 pin. The six pin's going to go to the sidewall. It's going to stand up. Then it's just going to lean right on the 10 pin.
Looking lean, baby. Looking lean. Fourth strike of this match for Jones.
Well, there's Tommy Jones, seventh frame. And this is what he's done on the right lane. This is a lane that he's been very successful on. You see about the 24th board. But this is the trouble lane, the left lane. You can see he's playing it much wider than he is on the right lane. A good two boards at the arrows and a good three boards down the lane. And again, the same result. The left lane has confused Tommy Jones throughout this entire match.
So just like that, Jones staring his second open frame. In the last three frames, he's bowled. So 132 through eight for Jones. Our Flomax weekly update focuses in on that man and his season in 08 and 09. Seven TV appearances, zero titles, but the second highest average in the PBA, just a shade under 223.
Well, Bill O'Neill, with just a slim lead, the last thing that he wants to see is a big split. Gets very fortunate there to only leave the four pin. A spare here, he will remain 10 pins ahead of Tommy Jones.
So we move to the foundation frame ninth, O'Neill up 10. O'Neill telling me he's been working out with the trainer this offseason, working on his core and leg strength, getting better shape. And I said, hey man, is it for the bowling or is it to get into the wedding tuxedo, right? He's getting married to that young lady, Christy White, coming up May of next year. I said, a little both. Get them all!
Nice break there. And with that strike in the ninth frame, Bill O'Neill can strike out to shoot 202. The best Tommy Jones can do right now is 192.
O'Neill has struggled the last three frames, but it's been on the left lane. Here he is on the right lane in the ninth. Oof, and the struggles move to the right.
3-4-6-10, just when it looked like Tommy Jones had that right lane figured out, goes right through the nose. And this is what's happening because of, in my opinion, what he's been doing on the left lane. He's afraid to get it just a little bit wide and leaving another 2-4-8-10 combination. Instead, he gets it going up the lane just a bit, right through the nose, pays the price.
Back to back open frames.
You don't see that very often, no. Taking the six spin out of the 3-6-10.
Well, we know what kind of competitor Tommy Jones is, and I think you and I can both realize what kind of mood he's in right now.
It doesn't matter what we do. We can play jacks, we can play PlayStation, we can play cards, we can play cornhole. It doesn't matter. I don't want to lose. And if I lose, I'm not going to be happy about it, and I'm going to be pretty bitter for a little while. I'm a terrible loser.
Well, maybe too little too late for Tommy Jones. He makes a ball change here in the 10th frame.
Oh, boy.
Not a whole lot he can do about it now. Bill O'Neill.
No chance.
With any markers in the 180s, Tommy Jones can only shoot 169. Very unusual grip. He puts his thumb in first, kind of corkscrews it in there, puts his fingers in last. Last player to do that with great success out on this tour, David Husted.
Finishing strong here on the left lane. O'Neill in great position to move on to take on Pete Weber in our next match, the three seed.
This is the toughest part about a one-game match. You better guess right coming out of practice going into that match. If you don't, this is what happens. Tommy Jones chose a different piece of equipment. Now he's going to sit back tonight and wonder what if he would have started with that ball.
Nothing but strikes in the 10th. He finishes with a 169.
Good one.
O'Neill needs 9. For the win. How about 10?
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
So O'Neill will move on. Up next for the real deal, PDW. Match number 2 when we return to Detroit.